The last match of the day in the great Southern clash between Otago and Southland. This is what they've stayed behind. New coach for this year for Otago and Roy Hawker, an accomplished sevens player, Buxton Popuali, player to watch out for. Paul Grant, another one who's worn the New Zealand colours. And Matt Faddis, man from Balclutha in 22. Marshall Suckling, who was a standout player last year on the bench along with Joe Hill, which is interesting, and the veteran Luke Herden also on the bench in Southland. Well, they got thumped by Taranaki, came back to beat Horowhenua Kapiti. Have to win this one. They're going to go through. So
here, Tony, 8 hours of sevens rugby. They've sat through, and they've sat through it, and they're waiting for this one. And the great thing is, there's plenty to play for too.
Lots of Southland fans, lots of Otago fans, and a roar goes up as Buxton Popuali fires the ball wide, and Otago it is who make the first attack from Matt Faddis. And the boy from Balclutha is going to score the first try. Great start, Otago.
Well, one of the quickest to 22 seconds. To open for Otago, the work done here. Popuali, the ball player, just a little step that drew the two defenders, that created the opportunity for Faddis, and that was all he needed.
Here, yeah, Buxton Popuali just showing his worth, little instant.
Picked nice and high. Kieran Moffat taking it down for Otago. Good determination too. Fighting back up towards the 22. Popuali, that beautiful step that he's got. He's a magic little player, this. Oh, he could be away. Oh, no, throws a loose one. Toe the head, though, by Faddis. He's got it, and he's going to score.
This is a cracker, Tony. Popuali, that's why he's such a good exponent of this game. The ability to step behind the foot. Untidy. Initially, the Faddis kept it under control and able to score.
Yeah. He's not available for the New Zealand team because he's in the wider training group of the Highlanders. Not the Highlanders, the wider training group. What sense does it make that he shouldn't be allowed to play in one? I don't get it. Well, Otago have got it. And they almost get over through Paul Grant, the skipper, and they should score here. That is queuing up. And they've got another one, it's Brad Weber. So two tries. So Popuali, he takes it quickly. Off he goes. Pass pulled in by Kieran Moffat for Otago. Away it goes to Weber, and he's got another one. He's got it. Now Otago, look to start the second half the way they finished the first. Here is Buxton Popuali. The one trying a couple of loose passes, but everything else he's done well. It doesn't really matter because they've been able to turn half chances into points. Otago finishing strongly. This is Kieran Moffat, and I'm afraid Southland's chances of playing in the top half of the draw tomorrow are gone for all. You have got certain people around to tell you off this time, Richard.
Excellent.
Just hope he's not already married, Tony. Well, that won't get me into trouble, get into a whole heap though. Lovely. I'm a magnet for marriage proposals. As a commentator, Tony.
Everywhere you go, people want to get married. But tomorrow promises much. And we look forward to bringing you every second of the action tomorrow on Sky Sport. Luke Herden's on the field and pops a nice little ball away too. And well, they could finish with another one here, Otago. This is a great try. It's Brad Weber. In fact, he popped the pass off and he goes, there you go. Luke Herden, who's been around the block, this fellow. He's played in a few tournaments now over the years. And he gets his first in this tournament. A big smile on his face at the end of the day. And they'll even let him convert the try, I think.
Well, he started it. Look at this for a lovely little offload. And good determination too from the big fella to back up, because this is a try, and he kept coming, and Brad Weber says, well, you deserve this.
because you've kept up with me. Didn't do that.
I'll tell you what, Luke Hurdon was the captain of the Otago team in my very last game here at the Nationals 9 years ago, and he's still going. That's brilliant.